What's the very latest on the red hot online sports betting category? Hi, everybody. I'm Pierre Bouvard, Chief Insights Officer at the Audioactive Group here at Cumulus Media and Westwood One.
The online sports betting category has been a very active category. There's about 15 states that have legalized online sports betting and more to come. We here at Cumulus Media Westwood One, we've been following the category. We conducted a major national study in April. We just completed another study in October. Now, what's the profile of the category? Who are the folks that are interested in online sports betting? Now, no doubt it leans male, but interestingly, it's not as young as you would think. The number one demo, half of the consumers interested in the category are 35 to 54, and then 40% are 21 to 34. So altogether, 21 to 54 represents almost 90% of those that are interested in online sports betting. Very little audience over the age of 55. Now, this 21 to 54 skew is important. Remember this slide as we start to look at TV viewers and radio listeners in just a little bit. Well, what else do we know about folks that are interested in the category? Well, it's not young single men. It's actually middle-aged family men, highly educated. In blue is the composition of those that are interested in sports betting. In gray is the profile of the total U.S. Very employed, college grad, family men, two-thirds have kids, and definitely a very strong income profile. Now, if we ask folks in the states that have legalized, name all the sports betting brands you can think of, as we did back in April, the number one answer is don't know. This is a new category. People don't yet have all the brand names on the tip of their tongue. Now, FanDuel and DraftKings, about one out of five people can name them on an unaided basis. After that, it drops down pretty quickly. Now, we just completed a study of aided awareness in October, and the big gainers are big Las Vegas gaming brands. First and foremost, Caesars Sportsbook has put a major promotional push. As you can see, they gained 25 points of aided awareness in October versus April. That's the rebrand of what used to be called William Hill. WynnBET grew 8 points of aided awareness, BetMGM 7 points. Golden Nugget and Bally Sports each gained 3 points. DraftKings and BetRivers gained 2 points, and Barstool gained about a point. So if you look at the 15 states in October where gambling, online sports betting is legalized, the big brands fall into kind of three tiers. First, you have DraftKings and FanDuel in the top tier. Next, you have BetMGM, Caesars, and Golden Nugget in the second tier. And then in the next tier, you have Bally, BetRivers, Barstool, WynnBET. So that's kind of the profile of the major players. But you can see there's lots of brands here. There were seven new brands that we added in this October study. Now, what about awareness of the brands in non-legalized states? So we looked at the rest of the country, the two-thirds of the country, and the major brands look very similar. DraftKings and FanDuel in the first tier, then Caesars, Golden Nugget, Bally, Barstool, BetMGM in the next tier. Now, you will notice that in the states that have not legalized, the aided awareness is about 25 to 50% lower. So there's definitely some brand building needed to be done. Now let's turn our attention to radio listeners and TV viewers. We wanted to understand what's the profile of media consumers and their interest in this category. So in blue, heavy radio listeners, in gray, heavy TV viewers. So to the left of your screen, ever placed an online bet? 42% of radio listeners, only 28% of heavy TV viewers. How interested are they? About one out of two heavy radio listeners say they are very or somewhat interested, less than a third of heavy TV viewers. And what about unaided awareness? How many consumers can actually name any sports betting brand? Well, about two-thirds of heavy radio listeners can name any brand, only about half of heavy TV viewers. So what's going on here? Why is it that heavy radio listeners are just so much more engaged and interested and likely to participate? Well, it really comes down to demography. Remember earlier we said this is a 21 to 54 category, very little interest over the age of 55. Well, let's take a look. According to Nielsen, on the left-hand side of your screen, the profile of the American linear TV audience is decidedly 50 plus. 78% of the audience of U.S. linear TV is over the age of 50. Only one out of five linear TV viewers are under the age of 50. So if you want to spend a dollar and reach the 18 to 49-year-old online sports bettors, only 22 cents of that TV dollar is going to go to reaching that 18 to 49 demographic. On the other hand, AM/FM radio, you can see, is really 50-50 composition, a much higher proportion of radio listeners that are in that 18 to 49 demographic. Now, if we look at the heavy radio listeners, the heavy TV viewers, and ask the question, well, what proportion of that audience says they are very or somewhat interested in sports betting? 40% of the heavy radio listeners, 30% of the heavy TV viewers. If you were to kind of roll that up to a ratio or percentage, it's about 57 for radio, 43 the TV. So if you wanted to find out where can I find people into this category, out of 100 people, you'd find 57 of them on radio and about 43 of the 100 people on TV. But that's not how the money's being spent. To the left of your screen, year to date, according to Kantar, for every dollar of TV and radio spent on online sports betting sites, 94 cents out of every dollar is going to TV, only 6 cents going to radio. And that, as you can see, is a real mismatch. The smart profile would be to do the 57-43 ratio, put 57% of an online sports gaming media budget onto radio, because just radio has way more of the people that are interested versus TV. So let's talk reach. In a typical week, what percent of radio listeners, radio is reaching the online sports better? About 86% nudges out TV at 82%. But look at podcasts. Two out of five online sports bettors are reached by podcasts. So let's dig into the podcast consumer. Interestingly, according to Nielsen Scarborough, podcast listeners 63% more likely to be sports bettors. And what kind of podcast genres can you find online sports bettors? Well, a whole variety: news, government history, comedy, society and culture, sports, business and tech. Notice that sports is not necessarily number one. And this is the big key finding here in terms of media planning, that the online sports bettors are found across a wide variety of podcasts, not just in the sports podcast. Now, let's talk about AM/FM radio programming formats. Where are the online sports bettors? Well, a big chunk of them are in the rock format. One out of five of those that say they're interested in online sports betting are found in rock. And then look at this. 10% of them can be found in classic rock, and then 10% in sports, and then 10% in new talk, and then 10% in urban country. So these folks that are into this online sports betting, they're not just in sports. They are all across the dial. They're all, you know, lots of different formats, lots of different podcast genres. So moral of the story is you need a mass reach buy to reach people that are interested in this category. You need at least a 60 reach. And to do that, you need at least 400 monthly GRPs on AM/FM radio to get a nice mass reach buy. Now, the buys that we've looked at in the market are only reaching in a typical month about 30%. So the GRP weight has to be dialed up. You have to diversify across all those programming formats to get a 60 reach. So The key takeaways here, here come the big brands, the big Las Vegas gaming brands in our just completed October national awareness study. They've really grown their awareness. Caesars significantly, but also WynnBET, BetMGM, Golden Nugget, and Bally have seen the greatest increase. And these are the same brands that have strong aided awareness in states that have yet to legalize online sports betting. All of the data from Scarborough and Nielsen, Maru, Matchbox say AM and FM should be the centerpiece. AM, FM radio listeners versus TV are just simply more engaged in online sports betting. They have more interest and greater awareness of the brands. The media plan needs to be diverse. Lots of different podcast genres and radio programming formats. And to hit all of those folks that are interested in the category and to build a brand, you're going to need a mass reach by at least 60% monthly reach. And to do that, you'll need at least 400 monthly GRPs. Each and every week, we publish a new case study and audio insight. You can find it on our blog, which is found either at cumulusmedia.com or westwoodone.com. And you can also sign up to get the weekly insight right into your email box. Thanks so much for the opportunity to share with you the very latest on the online sports betting category. Thanks so much.